up your YouTube, search for Stukely Meadows. Watch on your big screen.
Or another device if you're at home.
Get yourself comfy, this could take a while. What a happy scene. Something new every day for your long-term memory. This is so exciting, it is nearly time for a Stukely Assembly. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, or good night, everyone, and welcome to our Thursday Retrieval Assembly. You'll be pleased to know that Thursday Retrieval is back to normal. I've changed the video settings, I've done all the editing, we're now back to different year groups retrieving, which is great. For each other we, every day we, to improve we, together we will. Every single Stukely day we focus on. Our Stukely motto is. Our Stukely curriculum is. Our Stukely plan for home learning is. Four words that make the magic happen. Yes, they do. Hi everyone, it's Retrieval. I need assembly behaviour. Now, I was speaking to Mr. Partridge yesterday, speaking to Mr. Parters, and he said, when are we all going to go back in the hall for assembly? And I said, I don't know. I hope we go back to being all in the hall, but I think we'll keep to doing some YouTube assemblies. And I talked, him and I talked for quite a long time about it. And then Mr. Partridge said, when he goes round to the classrooms and he sees people watching assembly, he says, lots of the time the children are kind of sat slumped. You know, people aren't sitting up. Sometimes people are talking in the middle of assembly. Sometimes people aren't watching the screen. They aren't tracking the speaker. And so Mr. Partridge said, it's easier to do that when you're all in the hall together. And I said, yes, but I still expect the children to watch and track and listen in our YouTube assembly. So that's our reminder. Slant, please, everyone. I'd like you all sitting up, especially if Mr. Partridge catches you. I'd like you all listening. I'd like you all answering questions today. Definitely. Low battery. I'd like you to know your resources. Your resources are learning logs and pens and pencils if you're doing that. And you also need to track the speaker. I'm the speaker. Let's get ready for retrieval. Now, I'm not going to get dressed up today. I'm so excited about retrieval. I'm actually going to go back to my office at Stukely and do it in there. You'll see that in a moment. So you need your learning logs. You need to turn to the pages for this week. You need to write 1 to 6 down in your books, and it will be multiple choice, 3 mini questions. Here's the answer. What's the question? A sentence. And then I'm giving you all 2 questions from everyday knowledge, the new everyday knowledge. Okay. So this is it. Oh, oh, ho, ho, ho. That has never happened before. I don't actually know what's going on. Let's just forget that happened, right? Before we crack on, I hope you haven't forgotten pads. These are all about good manners, good attitude. Your please and thank yous. You're apologising. You're saying sorry when you've done something wrong before people tell you to apologise. Then you've got your door etiquette, your door behaviour. Opening doors, holding doors, waiting for people. And the most important one at the moment, wiping your feet before you go through a door to go inside. The S, I'm going to tell you tomorrow. Year 4 know it. They're not going to tell you, are you? Year 4, keep to yourself. Right, click on your year group. Let's get retrieving. Ah, hey Foundation Stage, I'm back in the office. Let's do your retrieval questions this week. We haven't done this for a while. Question number 1. Here are some answers. Here we've got some numbers. Can you tell me how many countries is the United Kingdom split into? So the UK, the United Kingdom, is a group of countries. How many? Number two, three quick questions and three quick answers, hopefully. Teddy has got three apples and his friend gave him two more. How many has he now got altogether? On the globe, the land is shown with green colour. What is the sea shown with? And last mini question, who did the snail travel around the world with? Question number three. The answer is Monet. What is the question? That's tough. That's tough, Foundation. Number four. How can we describe a special person? So can you think of some words to describe a special person? Question number five. When we dry our hands after we've washed them, if we're using a paper towel, if we're using a towel, a bit of paper, how many do we use to wash our hands? How many? And finally, question number six. Can you tell me which countries, what the names of the countries are that are in the United Kingdom? Off you go. Well done, Foundation. See you soon. Hello, year ones. I'm back in the office and we're back on retrieval. We haven't done this for a few weeks. Come on! Question number one. Here are some counties. Here are some areas, some counties in England. Which county is Huntingdon in? Which county is it in? Number two. Three quick questions, three quick answers. Living things like lions that eat meat are called what? So what do we call living things that eat meat? Which device do we use to control the cursor on a screen? And which part of a windmill allows the turbine and the sails to go round? Three questions there, off you go. Number three, the answer is equator. What is the question? Can you write it down for me, please? Number four. I need a sentence for this answer. I need a full sentence. What did Neil Armstrong say when the lunar craft landed on the moon? Can you write it down, please? Use your best spelling. Well done. Now, number five is from Everyday Knowledge. Can you write down the name of the painting? Oh, sorry, can you write down the name of a painting that Vincent van Gogh did? Write down one of his paintings, number five, please. And finally, number six. Number six. The Russian composer Prokofiev, he wrote a very famous piece of music called Dance of the What? Now, I know that one of the phonemes in the answer is what you've been working on. I know it's one of your sounds. So Prokofiev wrote Dance of the What? Off you go, well done. Well done, ones. Have a great rest of the day. Hello, year two. We're back in the office, my office, and we're back on retrieval, and it feels great. Question number one. Got some people, names of people here. Who is responsible for looking after our school environment? Who is responsible for looking after our school environment? Number two, three quick questions, three quick answers. Which ocean is the warmest? A habitat is the natural home of a what? And what type of art did Daisy Lunkunen paint? Write them down, number two, please. Question number three. The answer is algorithm. What's the question? Number four, I need a sentence for this, please. Number four, what is a microhabitat? Now you need to write, a microhabitat is... Off you go, please. Question number five, this comes from everyday knowledge. The Russian composer Prokofiev wrote a famous piece of music. That was awful. Anyway, he wrote a famous piece of music. It was called Dance of the Something. Can you write it down, please, number five? That was really bad. Sorry, you twos. And finally, question number six. Another question from everyday knowledge. Please, can you write down the name of the sculpture, the massive sculpture, made, built, created by Anthony Gormley? What's the name of his famous sculpture? Off you go. Thanks, you twos. See you soon. Hey, you three. I'm back in my office. We're back on retrieval. Come on! Oh, I feel good. Question number... Oh, hurt my muscles. I mean, they're kind of muscly. Question number one. We've got some counties here. We've got some areas in England, some counties. Which of these counties does not border Cambridgeshire? Which of these does not have a border with Cambridgeshire? Number two. Three quick questions, three quick answers. What is the French word for repeat? I grow underground, I am a root, and people eat me with fish. What am I? And how do we know that how do we know that 76 divided by 5 has a remainder? How do we know it's got a remainder? Write those down, number two. Question number three. The answer is 410 AD. The answer is 410 AD. What is the question? Write it down, please. Number four, I need a sentence answer. What problems did the Saxons and the Angles face when they came to the UK? What problems did they face when they came to the UK? And I need a sentence. Number five comes straight from everyday knowledge for you. Number five, Prokofiev, the famous Russian composer. He wrote a tune that goes... That was awful. Anyway, that famous piece is called Dance of the What? Write it down, please. Oh, and a bonus, the same one, number five. Can you write down the ballet it comes from? Go. And finally, number six. Can you please write down the name of the very famous sculpture by the artist, sculptor, Anthony Gormley? Write down probably his most famous sculpture, please. Well done. Have a good one, year three. Year four. I'm back in the office and we are back on retrieval. Question number one. Here are some dates. When did the Vikings invade and then settle in Britain? Which one, please? Write it down. Number two, three quick questions, three quick answers. Where did Bjorn dream of going to when he died? What is the French word for red? And what style of art did Picasso produce? Three answers there, please. Come on. Number three. It's a good job you don't have to write down the answer. Number three, the answer is esophagus. What's the question? Write it down, please. Question number four. I need a sentence for this. What does it mean to put something in chronological order? So your sentence needs to say, capital C, chronological order means, full stop, go. Question number five comes straight from everyday knowledge. Number five, what is the name of the famous piece of music composed by the Russian Prokofiev? Prokofiev. Write down what it's called and the ballet that it comes from, please. And finally, question number six. Can you please write down the famous one famous piece of art produced by Daisy Lunkunen. Can you write down one of her most famous pieces? Thanks, you four. Have a lovely rest of the day. Hello, year five. I'm back in the office and we are back on retrieval. Come on! Ooh. Oh, man. Question number one. Here are some ladies. Here are some names. Who was not one of Henry VIII's wives? Who was not one of them? Good question, Mrs. Wilner. Number two, three quick questions, three quick answers. How did the marriage of Henry VIII and Catherine of Aragon end? How long is one lunar cycle? And what do we call this moon? Good questions. Number three, the answer is full moon. What's the question? Write it down, please. Number four, who did Henry Tudor defeat at the Battle of Bosworth? I need a full sentence, please. Capital, full stop. Question number five is straight from everyday knowledge. Can you please write down the name of the composer, the Russian composer, who gave us Dance of the Nights? What is the name of that Russian composer? If you can give me first name as well, I mean, we're having a great time. And finally, question number six. Please, can you write down two famous artworks, two famous pieces by Antony Gormley and Leonardo da Vinci? Can you write down two pieces, please? Thanks, year five. Have a great rest of the day. Hello, year sixes. We are back in my office and we are back on retrieval. Just the way most of us like it. Question number one. Answers at the bottom. Which nutrient is responsible for growth and repair in your body? Number two, three quick questions, three quick answers. Henry Moore drew lots of pieces of war art which featured a particular place. Where was this place? What type of blood is transported in the aorta? And what does TNC stand for? They're not really quick answers, but off you go. Number three, the answer is 75%. What is the question? Good one, Mrs. Campbell. Number four, I need a full sentence for this. Explain brute force hacking. Capital B, brute force hacking is... Full stop. Number five, everyday knowledge question. Can you please write down three famous pieces of art by Daisy Lunkunen, Andy Warhol, and Leonardo da Vinci? Can you write down three? And finally, number six. Can you please write down the name of any famous composers that you know? I don't want their pieces, their musical pieces. I just want three composers or more. Off you go. See you later. Good work, everyone. Great to be back doing our retrieval. I mean, when I gave the retrieval sheets to your teachers, every single one of them said, thank you for giving us our retrieval assemblies back. We love thinking of questions to get our children thinking. All of the teachers said that, apart from Mrs. Hill. Anyway, joking, Mrs. Hill, she wasn't even here. Right, birthdays. Hey, 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 it's time to say we've got a Stoopy birthday. Hey, 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 it's time to say we've got a Stoopy birthday. Oh, come on! Happy birthday to Lewin in Foundation Stage. Happy birthday, Lewin. A great day with family, friends, lots of excitement, I hope. Have a good time. You're now five. Yippee! Right, let's finish with everyday knowledge for you. And we are learning to remember things worth remembering. Learning to remember things worth remembering. Learning to remember things worth remembering. Everyday knowledge for you. And we are learning to remember things worth remembering. Learning to remember things worth remembering. Learning to remember things worth remembering. Everyday knowledge for you. Okay, I promised you something brand new in Everyday Knowledge today, and we're going to do some science. Yes, we are. Before that, let's have a quick check on our arty pictures, our artwork. So I'm going to move over here. This is going to be really quick. It's going to flash up. I'm going to give you the fingertips, and you're going to just tell me the name of the artist. I just want the artist. Right, let's go. That's right, Andy Warhol. That's right, Vincent van Gogh. That's right, Leonardo da Vinci. That's right, Loon Koonin. That's right, Edvard Munch. That's right, Anthony Gormley. Well done, everybody. Oh, I hear a little tune playing. It's a very famous piece of music. I wonder, and this is tough, I know you find this tough. I wonder if you can tell me, oh, here's a little clue. I wonder if you can tell me the name of this piece of music. What is the name of the music? And what is the name of the Italian composer? I wonder if you can get that. I'll be really impressed if you can. We're gonna do this a lot. It's gonna get in there, I promise. Okay, give me the name of the tune and the composer. Okay, that's right, it's the William Tell Overture, and that composer is Rossini. Yes, it is. Okay, well done. Right, let's let that music fade out. Beautiful. Right, now, just to finish, we're going to talk science. Now, we're going to talk about some knowledge, we're going to talk about some information that's really for year 5, 6 children, and then year 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, adults. Never too soon. Elements. An element is the smallest part, is the teeniest part, the most basic part of everything around us. All of the matter around us, all the things around us, if you were to break it down into the most basic parts, they're called elements. Now, elements are mainly solids and gases, but there's also some liquids in there as well. Now, some of you will know that scientists over the last couple of hundred years, they have put all of the elements they found into a table. This table is called the periodic table. It's called the periodic table. And that's where scientists have put all of the elements that they've discovered in the world. It's about 100. Anyway. Elements are the smallest, most basic part of everything around us. And when they're in the periodic table, there are symbols. We write down symbols and letters to tell us what they are. And all we're going to do is learn a few of them. Starting off with O. If you look on the periodic table and you see O, and it's number 8, that stands for oxygen. Now, lots of you will have heard of oxygen before. It's a gas, and it's very important. I'm not going to tell you why. Teachers can explain. It's very important. Very important gas for us. So, oxygen is an element in the periodic table, and it's shown as an O. That's it. I'll test you on it tomorrow, and I'll add another one in. Have a good day, people.